worship now. Heaven is waiting for you to speak faint language. And usually, what your mouth is too heavy to say, heaven will refuse to approve it. The God of all flesh, he didn't just redeem us. He redeemed us and gave us the liberty to operate in the same class and category. According to Psalm 82, the Bible says, ye are gods. And the God who we are connected to, if you go back to Genesis 1, verse 2 and 3, he saw an earth that was void, without color, without form. The Bible says, the Spirit of the Lord hovers around. So in any crisis situation, don't speak until the Spirit has moved. As it is hovering based on the abundance of the heart. The day of trouble is not when soldiers prepare for war. What they do, they pull out ammunition. The day of battle is not the day they load it. The battle is not the time for preparation. The battle time is not the time for doing rehearsal. The battle time is the time to prove what you already have. So during test, trial, what are you saying? You can't believe and not speak in line with it.
Amen.
2 Corinthians 4:13 says, we believe, therefore we speak. We believe, therefore we speak. The confusion in our midst is our mouth is speaking one thing, our heart is saying another thing. Over, Charlie, how far now? He said, we don't know this thing. The Charlie that is talking to you is an agent who has come to further pull out what is in your heart. What's going on? Where we are still believing God. No, we have not believed anything. Somebody who has believed, you say,
amen.
People say, come and see, oh, come and see. Come and see what the Lord has done. Come and see what the Lord has done. Then somebody, they hear another voice in heaven. Come and see, oh, come and see. Come and hear, oh, come and hear. Come and hear what the Lord will do. Come and hear what the Lord will do. Which one will command the attention of heaven? The last one. Everybody will praise God when the miracle is already in your hand. But only few people will give sacrifice of praise in expectation, setting God up. You see people now when there's the testimony have already happened. The person who have never read the Bible read the Bible for 1 week. He will not read the Bible. Hey, praise the Lord. If the Lord is good, you need to read your Bible. That person, far, for 1 week, he has not read the Bible. So because he want to give testimony now, he has looked at the best scripture very well, very well. These are the things we experience today in our lives. But God is not looking for fire brigade operators. God is looking for consistent people. People who will live by faith on a daily basis. The school of faith says, we must call the things that are not as if they are, before heaven approves. And when we call, people around you will get wrong. You already tell the lies. We can't see. We can't see. So sometimes because we are intimidated, let me keep my mouth shut. The more we close our mouth, the more miracle pass us back. In this realm, in this realm, in this kingdom, until you say it, you can't have it. Let he or she that is waiting on the Lord for a husband begin to operate as if you are already programmed. You are preparing for the wedding. Amen. Let he or she believe in God for a time. Let it be that in your house there are children's stuff.
Amen.
That the day you born or you are conceived, that's when you want to buy baby stuff. You are not preparing for the miracle. Before you have it, you must already demonstrate it.
Amen.
And that's why sometimes miracles get you into trouble. As you are demonstrating it, people are calling you all kind of names. A woman had growth in her neck. For 1 year, she keep telling people, the Lord has done it. The Lord has done it. The Lord has done it. People to her, there was one of her neighbors, who keep ridiculing her. One day, he climbed the fence and was doing the normal ridicule. As he was speaking, the growth disappeared.
Amen. Hallelujah.
The man didn't need any pastor to preach. Right Amen. There, he gave his life to Christ.
Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Amen.
God will not move until you also show your partnership.
Hallelujah.
Miracle is between heaven and earth. It's a collaboration. It is partnership. Amen. You have to show that you believe God to the point of putting yourself across the line.
Amen.
The three Hebrew boys were not the only Jews in Babylon. But when the jungle get matured, they cross the line. Nebuchadnezzar, all protocols observed. Concerning this, we refuse to bow. The God himself will deliver us. But even if we choose not to,
Amen.
We will bow.
Amen.
And the Bible says, heaven was preparing
Amen.
To send truth. Heaven was preparing to send truth.
Amen.
Every other person have already bowed. Only three people standing. Only three people standing. And the Bible says, have you done all things?
Yes.
Ephesians 6, 13. Stand.
Amen.
God was speaking to me sometime last year that there are too many undelivered miracles. Why? He said, when angels come, we have relocated. I believe today, tomorrow I change. Because in the world we live now, there are too many options.
Yes.
If God didn't work, I can have authority. Any man, any woman that do business with God with a back door open, don't forget it. God will not share his glory with no one. If we must believe God for miracle in this month of the miraculous, we must focus. Only on God.
Amen.
If God won't do it, forget it.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And if God is your only source, is your only hope, you will sing with it.
Amen.
You will do all things with it. Praise